Hello, hello, hello. What is up, everybody? Thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoy it. It's not quick, but I tried to make sure I didn't miss out any big steps in it. I'm sure everybody has seen the floating candles on Pinterest and on YouTube already, but this is my little take on them. Instead of just having a little bit of hot glue, we end up using a ton of hot glue, but I think it is well worth it. So thank you everybody that requested this video, and I hope you enjoy. I'm gonna try and not talk all the way through it, so that way you can actually enjoy it with some theme music. And yeah, so if you have not subscribed already, please make sure you hit that subscribe button and stay tuned. So right here, this is the actual product that I had made that everybody had commented on, actually requesting a step-by-step video. I'm not going to quite do a step-by-step, more so just an individual piece so you get the overall idea. So you're going to need either a toilet paper roll, or you can use a paper towel roll or Pringles can, whatever you have. Some aluminum foil, a whole mess load of glue sticks. And when I say a whole mess load, we're going to use a ton of them. For just one candle, single candle, I probably use at least 50 glue sticks, if not more. Some scrap paper, this is going to go on the inside of the tubing. And of course, your hot glue gun. For the paint job, I used Finnebar's Art Alchemy waxes. I used the Mystic Turquoise in Antique Brilliance. I used the Amethyst Magic in Antique Brilliance. And I used the Royal Robes in Opal Magic. All three of these combined together really create a nice character for these candles. And just the colorization that I got from them, I could not have gotten from acrylic paints, really. If you can get your hands on these, get your hands on them. They're worth it for sure. And of course, you're gonna need a heat tool. This is gonna help us get rid of all the flyaways. I also did not show it here, but I do show it later on. I do use Art Basics heavy gesso in black. It's definitely worth it. I used to use acrylic black paint and regular gesso, but since I've gotten this, I realize the difference it makes. So real quick, I showed you that we put the paper on the inside. That's going to give us our tea lights a little base to sit on. And then here I am taking the foil and wrapping it in strips around the paper tube. It's going to help give us some more character, so we don't have to use as much hot glue. It's going to give us basically like kind of like making an outline to a sketch. So this is what's going to help us create that base. But I'm going to tune out here so you can actually enjoy this video. I'm going to pop in here and there just to add a little bit of commentary, but I don't want you to be too bored listening to me. I'd like you to enjoy the video. So yeah, enjoy. Thank you. So I just wanted to pop back in real quick. I'm just gluing in the extra flaps of the aluminum foil so it doesn't pop up when we take the candle in and out. And then I also forgot to show you in the beginning of the video the paper that I'm using on the bottom of this above my surface. It's just parchment paper from the Dollar Tree. I find it helps not let the glue stick to it. Basically, it comes off so easy. So we're gonna do the hot glue around the candle in about 3 or 4 different layers. This first layer here is gonna be just an overall base coating. We're not gonna really be concerned about filling up all of the gaps, more so just get that outer line and base down. And then later on we're gonna go through and add the second coat. Okay, so we're almost done with our first layer here. I went ahead and skipped forward just for time's sake. But this is gonna be our second layer here where we're gonna fill in all of these little gaps that we weren't concerned with before. And when we do these, we're not gonna start at the complete base. We're gonna start basically where that hole is and then work our way up. This is gonna complete our second layer and enjoy the rest. I'll come back to you shortly. All right. So that basically completes the second layer. Goodness, if I could talk. Now we're going to do the third layer, which we're going to do some candle drops, basically wax drops, about 1/3 to 2/3 down on the candle. We're not going to go all the way to the bottom, maybe a couple if you like to, whichever your preference is, but this is going to create that basically initial, almost initial layer of candle drippings on our candle. So stay tuned and we'll do one more layer after this. So I went ahead and skipped basically the whole third layer video just because, I mean, it's pretty simple. So this is going to be the fourth layer here where we're going to kind of encoat or encase the top portion. Be mindful when you do this part, you do not want the hot glue to go very far inside because earlier we measured it for the T-lay already, so we know it fits right now and we know it fits pretty snug, so we don't want to add any extra glue and make that harder to stick in. But this layer here, you're going to kind of go around that edge on that top and cover up any disconnection in between the both, kind of make it more cohesive, and of course take some of those faux wax, the, I don't know why I keep calling it wax, but you're going to take the hot glue and drip it down on a few spots to kind of make it more, blend more into the rest of the candle. And yeah, so stay tuned. I guess we're almost done here. I hope you enjoy. Alright, so at this point in the process, we have completed our hot glue. So you're going to need a heat tool for this next part, and I'm just showing you the other products that I'll be using next after this. But basically here, we're just going to be taking our heat tool and going around the candle and making sure we get all those loose extra flyaways from the hot glue that have been left behind from pulling away. Just keep in mind, it is hot glue, it will remelt, so don't focus your heat tool in any areas too long for too close, because it will remelt the hot glue. But just do it long enough to get all those extra flyaways, and then I'll come back to you shortly. Okay, at this point, we're going to do a couple layers of the black gesso to make sure we cover up all of these extra little shiny bits that are peeking through. That's going to be the aluminum foil that we put on there for structure, and we don't want any of that shining through and obscuring any of the waxes. So just make sure you go in with, I like to go in with that wide brush first to get the overall, and then I'll go back in with a small brush to get those little bits. And I ended up missing a few anyways, but I'm not too concerned about it. I got the majority of them, so the majority of it is covered. All right, so now's the fun part where we get to play with the waxes. Still one of my newest products, and I love them. I mean, they're not my products, I purchased them. But I would have wished I would have been brilliant enough to make them. Towards the end of the video, you can stay tuned. I do show you how to cover up the bottom. I figured most people wouldn't be interested in it since it is the bottom of the project anyways. So the first wax that we're going to go in with is the Antique Brilliance in Mystic Turquoise. And we're going to be pretty generous with this, covering up pretty much the majority of the piece, minus the deep nooks and crannies that we're gonna leave black for the deep shadows. Alright, I did go in with a second coat of the Mystic Turquoise just because I wanted I really wanted it to pop through everything. So the next color I'm going to go in with is the Antique Brilliance and Amethyst Magic. This one, we're going to kind of blend into the turquoise quite a bit, and then we're going to go in with another bit over the top of it. But we're not going to be as generous with this one because we really want it to blend in with that turquoise and kind of get a nice mixture, so that way it really shimmers and shines and the colors transition well in the lighting. All right, time for the third layer of the waxes, and it's going to be Opal Magic Royal Robes. This color is really awesome on black surfaces. It comes into a bright, bright pink, and it just transitions and brings that final highlight layer on this piece, just pulls it all together. And just keep in mind, I do point out at one point here, if you're not careful, it'll leave behind white spots, and that's just basically from thicker parts of the wax being stuck from your sponge. So just keep an eye out and go back through and make sure you don't miss any of those, and make sure you blend them back in. And yes, thanks again for watching. Stay tuned. I do show you again how to do the base if you're interested, and be sure to like and subscribe and follow and all that YouTube good stuff, because I do look forward to putting out some more videos here. And thanks again for watching. I hope you enjoy. One last bit I wanted to add, Remember, this project is handmade and it is made from paper and foil and glue and wax. So the candle that I use is just because I did not have a battery operated tea light handy. So please make sure if you do make this in the future and you use a actual candle, it could be a fire hazard, so I do recommend to use a battery operated tea light or do not plan on burning them. It is purely for decorative purposes, it is not an actual candle, so forth. Disclaimer, disclaimer, disclaimer. And again, thank you all for watching and enjoy.